How are you doing? So we have been exploring January so far in the last 2 weeks, and I'm just curious, how has January been so far for you? How are you getting on with the new energies from the new age of Aquarius? I've been speaking about this already in my last, also in my last few videos, but now we are here. How are we experiencing this? I think what I wanted to share with you is that, you know, we constantly speak about spiritual enlightenment and spiritual awakening and all of that stuff, and we always think about everything is always about positivity, right? And we want to be euphoric and whatnot. And to really be straight honest with you, I think that can also work a little bit toxic on us as well, because within even our, you know, spiritual developments, personal development, new age awakening and whatnot, we get presented this image, you know, like everything always should be positive, right? We all always should be coming from a place of you know, being euphoric. I gotta be honest with you, I mean, I'm not gonna lie, and I think you already started to notice that in my last few videos as well. I didn't really got a lot of traction, of course. Don't blame anyone on that. But I think many empaths can experience right now a little bit of a time of feeling sluggish, okay? And there's no shame in that, I think. Sometimes we just need to accept these moments where we are picking up the heaviness from the world, the sadness, the frustration, the anger, feeling isolated maybe. And you know, we feel like there's like a lot of pressure on the 3D world right now, you know, this power and control and all of that, you know, messages of gaslighting in our mainstream media, at least that's how it feels like. Like we, the people, are the bad ones at fighting for what we believe in and being labeled as the one that is fighting against, I don't know, the system or whatever. Okay, well, I think there's no shame at sometimes admitting that sometimes we just need time for ourselves, maybe just really to reflect on that, and sometimes we just need to give ourselves a break at recognizing, like, wait a minute, right now we live in a very transformative time, a time where more of our inner self, the true self, wants to break through, right? And all of that that is not really longer serving us, it's like bomb popping to the surface. I mean, like last week, sometimes I'm still following the news of what's going on in my own country, because my roots are still there, my family lives there. But the government in the Netherlands has fallen. Can you imagine? A very wealthy country in the European Union has fallen because of some government corruption. I mean, I always said it from the beginning, even the government in the Netherlands is corrupted. I said it like 10 years ago, and now this came to the surface, and we see it everywhere, political chaos and everything that's going on. We feel we just don't really want to participate in this world anymore, but yet we still live in that world. It's, we are still surrounding ourselves with it. We still have our daily things that involves engaging in that world that is just simply falling apart in front of our very own eyes. And people are getting upset, they're getting angry, they're getting frustrated, which is very understandable. I get frustrated with it, I get angry about lots of things, and we want to get back to what is most familiar to us. And what is around the corner, I can assure you, nobody knows exactly what is around the corner, and everything feels still very unfamiliar to us. And that is, of course, what the ego will resist. In my own personal case, I mean, over the last few years, I've been opening up and exploring my spirituality and following all these different courses I have done, I started to notice, like, wait a minute, maybe I do have an intuitive, spiritual, empathetic gift that is to be shared with the world. But Like everybody has an ego that is always wants to do what is most familiar and resist the unfamiliar. That is, you know, standing of course in its own way. And especially again, you know, because also my own world has been falling apart. Jobs and everything that just didn't really serve my true nature, true authentic self, has been completely falling apart. So the stress that comes from, you know, economic uncertainty and insecurity, of course sometimes we don't really want to face that type of stress, worry, anxiety, and you know, we just want to hide from it, right? That's also what a lot of intuitive sensitive empaths will do. They want to hide from it, from facing this dark reality, maybe. Find ourselves in distractions or addictive behaviors because we don't really want to face a certain type of reality. So, but now I think it's really the time to really acknowledge our true inner self, to let it come out what has to come out. And it's no longer the time for half-assing, because what the world needs is of course authenticity. It's of course more love, more kindness, more light, more surrendering, more allowance instead of more resistance, because that will be the new world we choose to live in. So that's of course the whole idea. And like I also said in my previous videos, what I've been exploring in my meditations as well, it's that the door between our highest states of consciousness and this lower density has become very thin. The layers has become very thin, so we could explore these wild unexplored territories of our own minds, of our own souls, and move up through these different states of higher consciousness, higher being, increase our vibrational frequency just in the corner in our own dark room. And even when it feels like we're not supposed to go out and travel in our 3D physical world anymore because of all the rules and the restrictions, and it feels like our freedom has been taken away and all the control, all the pressure, but still we can stand in our own true powers from even from the limited space we have. And it feels like a lot of us, we feel like we are like imprisoned at the moment. And so many have been telling for so long, the movie The Matrix wasn't a movie, it was a documentary. And we have heard it so many times before, and this matrix is like the veil slashed over our eyes, that we are not supposed to see this unknown of our own unexplored territories that are hidden inside ourself, that has to be revealed, our true nature, our true self. And how more we align ourselves with that, bring more of that in and let that come out in our day-to-day activities, create our own work, create our own business from even the corner of our own room, and shine our light with the world in that way. So now the question of course is like, hey, what was January, what has it done for you? To be honest, I felt like a lot of pressure, a lot of anxiety, a lot of worry. I didn't feel like doing anything at all. I felt sluggish. I was completely surrendering myself to my distractions, addictive video game behavior and whatnot. And even though I knew like, okay, I gotta commit to this meditation thing and whatnot, at a moment I just couldn't really feel bothered with it. Of course, that's a part of the ego that wants to resist. That wants to resist the unknown. And I think right now it's really the time for us to also to recognize that, overcome it, and choose to let go, and align ourselves more with that what gives us more joy and fulfillment, because when we do so, we can bring more of that energy, and then we start to notice, like, wait a minute, my distractions is just not longer worth it, because now I can draw in this flow, this abundance flow, much quicker and much faster, as long as I keep my mind and my body and my soul and my heart into it, the rest will follow. And that kind of trust and allowance and surrender, it's sometimes that these are the last steps that has to be overwon. These are the battles we must fight, not what is out there or anything that is going on there, because we cannot fight these battles. The only battle we can win is our own corner, the own corner of our own universe. And that's really what we must be focusing on. So I'm going to leave it with this. How has January been so far? Please let me know. Simply just drop a comment below. And what are these last steps for you that you have to conquer and overwin? Please let me know. Simply drop a comment below. And I look forward to see you on my next videos. Take care for now. Bye bye.